In this video tutorial, you will learn to run the Statement of Operations Research Report. The Statement of Operations Research Report is an account-level summary of detailed information for a single project. In this video, you will learn how to access and run the Statement of Operations Research Report, understand the layout of the report and interpret your results, perform the monthly reconciliation process, and where to find useful resource information. First, I'll start with a general overview of the report. A few tips to keep in mind when you run the Statement of Operations Research Report. New financial reporting functionality provides data on your project that is, at most, 24 hours old. Previously, access to research reports was limited to 13 months, the most recent month plus the previous 12 months. You now have access to research reports that span the whole life of the project. If you are running the report for the purpose of viewing an up-to-date balance, consider what monthly transactions have not yet been posted to the general ledger when selecting the current fiscal period. For example, these entries might include the monthly telephone and courier costs, purchasing card transactions, the monthly payroll and benefit distribution, and related commitment adjustments, just to name a few. It is important to remember that if you are running the report for the purpose of reconciling your monthly Statement of Operations research, please generate this report on or after the second business day following the month-end close. This will ensure that all final revenues and expenses and related commitment amounts are captured and reflected in your reports following the month-end close. Please note that overhead will be charged to applicable projects generally one business day following the month-end close. The month-end reporting schedule can be found on the Financial Services website. The report can be viewed electronically on the screen or downloaded to Excel or PDF. You also have the option of emailing the link of the pinned report to another user. I will now show you how to access your research reports. To run research reports in FAST, users are required to have project security access. To add or remove access, the principal investigator must complete and sign the Signing Authority and Portal Access Research Funds form, available in the Track Researcher Portal through the Research Accounting Event form. For more information on completing and submitting the Research Accounting Event form, please see the video tutorial available on the Track website. Once you have correctly set up your project security access, sign into the MyQueensU Solus portal using your QueensNet ID and password to access FAST financial reporting. The MyQueensU Solus portal is available from the drop-down menu in the top right-hand corner of the Queens homepage. Once in the portal, click on My Applications. The link to the research reports is available in the Financial Reporting Information section. For your convenience, we have included the links to the most popular research reports, such as Project Summary, Statement of Operations Research, Transaction Detail Revenue and Expense, and Account Payable Details. In the Research Project Summary Report video tutorial, also available through the Financial Services website, users learn how to view summary-level financial information of all research projects. Click on the Statement of Operations Research link to run the report. You are now at the Filter Options screen. From here, you can select how you want the report to run by choosing filters. The available filters are Fund, Department, Account, Program, Class, Project, and Fiscal Period. Filters can be added by entering a value in the search box and clicking the green plus button. Individual filters can be deleted by selecting the value to be deleted and clicking on the red X button. All filters can be cleared at once by clicking on the Clear Filter Options button in the bottom right-hand side of your screen. Multiple filters for fields such as program or class can be added and arranged by separating the two values with a colon. Or they can be added as non-consecutive values by inputting each value individually using the green plus button. To select a date, click on the fiscal period drop-down menu and select a specific month and year. For this example, let's assume August 2014 is the current month. You may also click on the function button and select a specific date criteria, such as current fiscal period. Please note, the fiscal period and project filters are required to run the Statement of Operations research report. Once you are satisfied with your filter criteria, click on the Execute Report button to run your report. I will now explain the different features of this report. The report drop-down options allow users to change some of the filter criteria originally selected to run the report. For example, you can change the period for which you are running the report from the period drop-down menu. If you change one of the filters, the report will run, again, based on the new criterion. The filter trail shows the project number, project name, and project end date. Click on the hyperlinked filter trail to return to the filter options screen. Remember to click on the Execute Report button again if you change any of your report criteria. I will now describe the different columns that make up the report. Budget to date represents the posted budget on your submission when your grant or agreement was awarded. Current month actuals represents the revenue and expense activity based on the selected date criteria used to run the report. Project to date actuals represents the revenue and expense activity for the project from inception based on the selected date criteria. Before I describe the next columns, there are a few details regarding commitments you should be aware of. Commitments represent known future expenses that have not yet been incurred. Commitments may relate to salary and benefits, purchase orders for goods and services, or overhead. Commitments will always be reported with account codes ending in 00. For example, amounts reported for account 502300 represent salary commitments for postdoctoral non-student salaries. Amounts reported for account 600000 represent committed amounts for a related purchase order, and amounts reported for account 693000 represent overhead commitments. Important points to keep in mind when looking at salary and benefit commitments. Commitments will not be reported until after the first salary payment has been made. For example, if a salary contract is approved in June and the first payment is made in September, the related salary commitment will not be reported until September. Furthermore, salary and benefits are not necessarily committed to the end of the project. Therefore, if salary contracts extend beyond April 30th, the commitments which apply to the months following April will not be reflected in the report. For contracts that extend beyond April, the salary and benefit commitments will be reflected once the first salary payment has been made in the new fiscal period. Once a salary contract has been approved, it may extend beyond the available funds within the research project. If this situation exists, and the salary and benefit commitment needs to be changed to another research project, a new salary contract must be created with the revised chart field values. The amended contract will supersede the original contract, and the future salary and benefit commitment will be removed from the original project. The commitments column represents the outstanding commitments for the year based on the selected date criteria used to run the report. Commitments may include purchase orders, salary and benefits, or overhead activity, with the exclusion of casual labor and the related benefits. Budget balance with commitments represents budget to date minus the sum of project to date actuals and outstanding commitments for the year, based on the selected date criteria. Projects favorable/unfavorable versus budget represents the percentage under or over budget for each revenue and expense category. You will see an F for favorable if expenses are within budget or revenues exceed the budget. You will see a U for unfavorable if expenses exceed budget or revenue is less than budget. This is calculated by dividing the budget balance with commitments column by the budget to date column. Revenue balance with commitments represents the project to date actuals plus outstanding commitments for the year based on the selected date criteria. You may have noticed that the budget balance with commitments and the revenue balance with commitments columns have different totals, and you might be wondering which column you should pay the most attention to. This depends on the type of research project you are running the report for. For projects which have a firm budget, such as Tri-Council projects, the most relevant column is the budget balance with commitments, since spending is based on the budget, regardless of when the revenue is received. Other types of projects earn revenue based on events such as milestones, receipt of overhead revenue, or the accrual of clinical trial subjects. The budget for these projects is not guaranteed, therefore spending should be based on the amount of revenue received or expected to be received. For these projects, the revenue balance with commitments is the most relevant calculation. I will now briefly describe the different rows that make up this report. Total revenues represent the sum of all actuals and budget activity for all revenue. Total labor represents the sum of all actuals, commitments, and budget activity for all salary and benefit expenses. The commitments in this section relate to salary and benefits. As salary and benefit expenses are incurred, salary and benefit commitments will be reduced. Total non-salary expenses represents the sum of all actuals, commitments, and budget activity for all non-salary expenses. The commitments in this section relate to purchase orders. You may notice that your project report contains overhead-related details. Overhead expenses do not apply to all research projects. One way to determine if your project will be charged overhead is if a budget is reported next to account 693000. If your report reflects a budget next to this account, your project will be charged overhead expenses according to the grant or contract terms. The example used in this video is a Tri-Council grant and, as such, was not charged overhead expenses. Total all expenses represents the sum of all actuals, commitments, and budget for all expenses. Total represents the net of all revenue and expense activity. Remember that you can always drill down on any value that is hyperlinked to view the transactions that support these figures. Reconciling your Statement of Operations research report is an essential step in monitoring the activity posted to your project. The process ensures all transactions posted to your accounts are accounted for and brings to your attention the outstanding items not yet posted that you will want to follow up on. The best way to perform the process is to run your monthly report and click on either the month actual or project to date actual hyperlink total. Remember to run your report for a closed period using the project and fiscal period criteria of your choosing. In this example, I ran the report as of August 2014. Scroll down to the bottom of your report to see the total row. Click on the hyperlinked value in the August 2014 month actuals column to see all transaction details for that month. You can either view the transactions in FAST or download the transaction details into Excel. To reconcile transactions for more than a month, click on the hyperlinked value in the Project to Date Actuals column to see all the transaction details inception to date. Export the data to Excel using the Excel icon in the bottom right-hand corner of your screen. This will allow you to check off or match each entry to your records or source documents and then file the Excel report electronically. The report downloaded into Excel will indicate the date the report was generated, as well as the filter criteria applied to generate the report. Once you have exported into Excel, you can filter by period to look at transactions for a specific month. Back in FAST, you can drill down on the hyperlinked journal IDs to see further details. For example, if you click on an accounts payable journal entry, you will see which vendor was paid, the invoice number, etc. Please note that this functionality is only available in FAST, not from the downloaded Excel or PDF reports. Benefit allocation journals begin with the prefix RSA, while accounts payable transactions begin with AP. For a complete list of transaction source codes, please contact Research Accounting at research.accounting@queensu.ca. For more information regarding the Statement of Operations Research Report and other financial reports, the Financial Services website hosts a wealth of information. Thanks for taking the time to watch our video tutorial on the Statement of Operations Research Report. More video tutorials on the FAST financial reporting tool are available through the TRAC and the Financial Services websites.